Hi, everyone. Before we begin, I'm up here to let you know, of course, where the fire exits are. They are there, 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 and there. So if there's a fire, please make sure that you calmly exit to the nearest exit and then go outside. And I wanted to thank you all for coming out tonight. And please turn off your cell phones. I hear there's been an Amber Alert going around making the, alert noise, and we prefer not to have that during our performance. So if you can silence or turn off your cell phones, that would be great. Thank you. We'll see you in a moment.
Well, thank you all. And thank you for bringing better weather with you in the evening than we had on the way down here. Floods, torrents and everything. So we were thinking about what we were going to play. It might be Spirit of the Storms or something like that. Might get you into the mood. But instead we've opened up this evening's concert with Shining Force 2. And we're now going to move on to a second item, which is a piece entitled 2000X. Thank you very much. I'm now going to take the opportunity to introduce to you the first of this evening's soloists. We like to take the opportunity wherever we can do to showcase a couple of people within the choir. And tonight we're going to be joined by Holly Wu, who is going to sing for you a piece that I suspect 50% of you, if our takes and our comments from the audience in previous concerts is anything to go by, about 50% of you are going to say, yeah, that's great, and 50% of you are going to say, well, I don't know what that is at all, but I'm sure that 100% of you are going to enjoy Holly Wu as she sings for you, Staying Alive. Still alive. People have spent months and months saying, I must not say Staying Alive, but guess what?
Ha ha! Fair chance!
Anyway.
Thank you, Holly. We're right. Well done, Holly. Thank you very much. So, I don't know about you, but I'm stuck on this island somewhere. And I don't know what to do. Every lever I pull, every door I open, every button I press, every book I read, every hidden entrance I go in, every secret message I listen to, still gets me nowhere. I look at that book, and I'm supposed to look at it, I'm supposed to press it and go to it, but that doesn't work. So if anybody's got any clues about how we might get this game to work, let me know. And don't say Google for the answer and all that sort of stuff, because I want to feel honest when I cheated. One of the great things about this orchestra is not only its amazing board and its amazing players, but also we've got a number of amazing people who arrange great pieces of music for us. And they're all me, we're going to come back to that later, behind me here. And one of them, Rob Gardner, has penned this, I think, truly atmospheric and amazing arrangement of Mist. Thank you. I mentioned earlier that not all of the pieces of music that we will be playing for you tonight are arranged by people behind me. The history of the orchestra is such that it came out from alumni from the University of Maryland, Gaynor Symphony Orchestra, and when they graduated they thought, well, this was pretty good, we really don't want to give up, we want to keep going, so they got together and decided to do that. Without any music, they thought, well, perhaps we'll just, while no one's looking, don't tell anybody, take a couple of their pieces of music. No one knows. Just us, them, and you, and the whole of Ukraine, it seems. One of the pieces of music which we've got hold of and we've been able to use is the next piece, and it's called Oom Butamut. Thank you. So you'll see someone coming up here now. That's because this is the second of this evening's solo spots. And it's one of those tunes that if you know it, you can never get it out of your mind. It's over and over again. You try to get to sleep and there it is, it's getting on your nerves, and it's in the back, and it just won't go. The trouble is, the reason for that is it's such a fantastic tune. It was award-winning, and everybody knows it who's anything to do with games. And I'm not surprised, because it's such a great setting of the Lord's Prayer in Swahili. As I introduce to you Chokuzo Monsoon, who's going to sing for you a setting of Baba Yaga. Actually, before I go there, does anybody here know what the beef is with Gandhi?
Thank you. Thank you.
And with that number, which was Zelda's Lullaby, we're now going to come to the last item in the first half of this evening's concert by the Washington Metropolitan Gamers Symphony Orchestra. After which there will be a short intermission, about 10 minutes or so, while we set up the stage for the second half. The first half finishes with Hikari.
Thank you.
next piece I want to introduce is called Lullaby Set. It's a very nice piece from Braid featuring Lara Stamen on violin and Michael Brancato on piano. And I'll get out of your way so you can see them. called Free ZZ Peak from Banjo Kazoo. There's a timer. I will have them come out here.
Thank you.
talk to you a little bit. Thank you all so much for coming out tonight. My name is Ayla Hurley, and I'm the president of this amazing ensemble. We are very thrilled to perform for the first time. To tell you a little bit about us, the WMGSO is a group of musicians from the DC metro area who come together over a common interest, playing video game music, also sometimes playing video games. Just off stage. Better not be on stage. It is our primary mission to share game music with you because it's our passion, and it moves us all in very profound ways. Like all art, it is so diverse and wide-reaching that all of us have been touched by it in some form or fashion, by its depth, its complexity, its emotion, sometimes just its ability to help pass the time. Music is a language which bypasses words, and we strive to tell the stories in this language that embody timeless human experiences. It's our hope that through our performance, you don't need to know much about any particular game to know what it's like to experience playing the game. The piece that the full ensemble is about to perform for you is really good at this. I haven't played this game yet because I can't get it to work on my computer, but the music is touching. It's amazing. So I have a couple of people I want to thank. First of all, I want to say thank you to our illustrious music director, Nigel Horn, who I want to take a moment to say thank you to all of our wonderful supporters and our donors. They've contributed to us, and by doing so, they are our heroes. They help us provide rehearsal space, equipment rental, everything else that we need to do what we do. If you're interested in becoming a donor or a supporter, please speak with the event staff in the lobby. They can get you signed up for that. I also want to thank the Montgomery County Arts and Humanities Council for giving us the Creative MOCA grant this season, which has allowed us to have our first performance in Rockville so that we could direct our other funds to having this performance here in Dominion. So I want to thank Dominion High School for letting us perform here in this very nice venue. All of our event staff volunteers who are helping out in the lobby and helping usher. I want to thank Brendan Madden and Adam Nash for helping out on percussion and in the band you just saw. And I want to thank a few folks from Montgomery Philharmonic and the Victorian Lyric Opera Company for helping fill in some seats with us this season. Their help has been greatly appreciated. So please let us know what you thought of tonight's show by using the feedback form that's tucked away into your programs. And I want to thank you again for coming out tonight. We hope you enjoy the rest of the concert. And if you can't wait until December to see us again, please check out Super Smash Con in August, where we will be performing. It's a very cool weekend convention in Dulles. So I highly encourage you to look at that. I now present to you the Ballad of Commander Shepard.
so much. You know, it's usual at this time for people to say, I couldn't have done it without. And as it gets a bit, you know, you expect this thing to happen. But in my case, this is true. There are, apart from the wonderful and amazing musicians, and would you believe that in terms of concerts, they've only been going for a year. There are two sets of people, and I really hope that I don't forget anybody here, because I'm prone to do that. There are two sets of people I'd like to thank. As a director, as a musical director, quite often one comes in and has to do absolutely everything with a group. This is not true with this group, and that's what makes my life so easy. All I need to do is wave my arms around a bit, turn around, and think everybody is a think that everybody thinks I'm absolutely awesome as a result, and that's all I've done. But I couldn't have done it without the board of directors, most of which are in this room, and one of which is outside probably grabbing whoever's money he can. So we have Ayla, our amazing president. And we have Joe, our VP, doing running around with just about everybody's dog's body. Then we have Rob on the back row, who is our press release, so without him, he wouldn't have known about it. And there is, oh, there she is. How have I forgotten you? There is a secretary here, as well as being the concert master, the principal violinist, the violin extraordinaire doing that solo with the piano. That's tremendous. Out there somewhere. He's probably out the front, so I can't see him. He was taking all of your money, Chris Apple, the treasurer. As well as the board of directors, we have some administrators. The key administrator is Jason, who is there, who's our IT guru, who does the website. These people to knowing what the rehearsals are. So that's our first group. The second group of people I really need to thank are those talented musicians behind me who have penned all of the music, apart from those that we don't talk about, that might have disappeared from the University of Maryland's library at some time. These people are those that have decided, we're going to write something, I want to write something, I want to have something heard by the orchestra, because you can't go down to, well, you can't even go into Amazon, it's pretty amazing, and get music for video game groups. So, now this is where I'm going to miss out on somebody, but I'm going to try to remember all of the arrangers. Lara over the back there, she helped with 2000X along with Jason there. Jason over the back did our first number, and he's done some of the other ones that we've done. Rob there, who did the pretty amazing, awesome mix. So, with that, I'd like to say thank you, and we're going to play you out, having introduced you to Jamin, we're going to play you out with an extra item, his setting of Crystals of Evans.
Thank you.